Sorry, what was that? You challenge me to fly the Dash 8 with a can of cider. Wait a minute, why is there two Dash 8s there? Oh, it's, I got static scenery on. Slow mode! Problem solved. Well, that was off to a good start, wasn't it? Funnily enough, that object loaded in after I'd already started. Brilliant. Love it. So, anyone recognise this place? All the flybee might be a giveaway. Freeze over there. Anyone recognise it? Anyone recognise it? Small little airport. Oh, it's at the bottom of the flipping screen. I started fly load too early. Yes, we are at Southampton. And you'll see the destination is EGNX, East Mids, my home airport. So, yeah, short little hop from Southampton to the mighty Loughborough. So, yeah, really, really looking forward to this. Well, a bit north of west of Loughborough, Castle Donington, but anyway. Close enough. It's close enough to home. Yeah, real world weather. So we've got it absolutely chucking it down at the moment at Southampton. It's actually quite nice outside here. So I'm expecting that we'll be landing in the sun. At least if it's anything like looking out the window at the moment. First things first. Friday. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, mucho needido. Cool, right, so I've done the PFPX. I've got the Crash 8 now set up in PFPX. Let me show you that. So Southampton up to East Mids, I've got Birmingham as the divert, which is a bit of a hawky-borky route, but anyway, in the Peru. Whatever, we're not going to be diverting. Looking outside, it's a little bit windy, but fine. So yeah, quite short little flight. 45 passengers decided to brave it with me today. RIP. And we've got a bit of cargo as well. So in the Q400 Majestic Q400 configuration majiggy, I've loaded all those numbers in. Had to do a little bit of jiggery pokery with the mass, with the baggage and where it was going, because if you've done the Dash 8 before, you'll know it takes a bit of thinking about to actually balance the aircraft, and I've actually managed to get it slap bang in the middle of the flight envelope there. You'll see that's actually pretty good for the Dash 8. Normally I'm operating sort of right up in one of these corners, and it handles like an absolute brute. And I've got the passengers spread out, so, you know, you would stick them all in the middle, really, to reduce your moment of inertia, but I've spread them out, why not? And the baggage is all... more in the back than I thought it was going to be, actually. I thought we were going to have to stick a load in the nose, but apparently not. Yeah, so all the numbers are in. We can send that to the flight sim. There we go, lovely. And then we can have a bit of a look-see at what's going on. Whenever you send that to the flight sim, it pauses, so we'll unpause. There we go, lovely job. Right. This one can get stuff straight away. Don't need that. Off. Excuse me, off. There we go, lovely. Parking brake can come on. We're ping-ponging because for some reason it's not coming cold and dark. I could click buttons, but meh. Sounds like effort. So, weather's on. Don't need COM 2. Or that one, because, yeah. Reasons. Excuse me. Hey, no.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on board our Dash 8 Q400. We're just waiting for the last of the luggage to be loaded on board, then we'll be able to get underway in a few minutes. On behalf of the entire flight crew, I wish you a pleasant flight.
Right, I realised watching back one of my videos from last weekend that the FSX audio was basically inaudible. No. I've never noticed that before. So I'm playing about with the levels. I'm literally just looking at the level meter at the moment. But hopefully that's a bit better. Does it actually play music when the passengers are coming on? What? Why did Flybe go out of business? Oh, no. That's a disaster. Tell you what, I don't remember them playing music when I flew Flybe. But anyway, whatever. Main bus tie can come on, that's fine. Just going to flick some buttons first of all, get everything ready to rock and ruin. Hopefully that music doesn't then start a bloody copyright infringement thing on YouTube, because that would be a bit of a bugger if it did, but whatever. So fasten seatbelts can come on, doors could not be armed at the moment because they're open. Whatever. And we will assume everyone is on board good and proper, and all the fuel is on, so we'll close some of the doors up. Close. Trigger. There shouldn't be too much of a challenging route, it's just the fact that it's a wee bit windy at the moment in the up. So now, right, here's a question. I can't remember how you load a route in on car. So we will go to, first of all, do I need to do any of that? Apparently not. Because we've not got our IRS turned on. I don't think we could not have it turned on in this, can we? No. We'll assume that's all good. We're not online. We might do another flight later online for a couple more jars. The worst that could happen, as Bill would say. So that's not what I want. I want flight plan, that's what I want. Copy. Block route. It's not going to be in here, I'm sure of it. No, it's not. We're going to have to do it the old-fashioned way then. We shall key it in. If I can remember how to do that. How do you even do that? Oops. Nope. How did you get out of that, though? Keep positive waypoint? No, it's not that either. Elite flight plan? Yeah, go on then. Left PDHI. Yeah. Ah, right, here we go. This is what I want to do. Why has it vanished? No, no. Anyway. EGMX, enter. Accept. Why does it keep deleting? What? I'll put it in here. I have done this before, believe it or not. It's not what I want, though. I need to tell the aircraft where we're going from and to. From BGA. Oh, do I have to put PDMF into there? Ah, this looks promising. Thing is, what I'm looking for is how I'll put the tracks in and such. I'm sure somebody is screaming at me at the moment. Not really. Right, I'll tell you what, let's start keying some things in and see what happens. Thankfully it's a short route, so there's not actually that many waypoints. So we have Pepis. Pepis. Enter. That. But how do I do... I want you to follow a track. Or an airway, should I say. Like a vial. Ah, oh, this looks promising. Pepis 2. Cowley. Ah, which is number 4. Ah, oh, there we go. That's what I wanted to do. Right. And then from Cowley. Oh no, we wanted to go to Silver. P41 Silver. There we go, right there. Yeah, yeah. And then we want to go via Mike 605. You know that. There we go. Mike 605 to Coventry. Enter. And then from Daventry, the home. There we go. Oh yeah, that I can never remember how you do that. So now we want to do departure. Ah, right. Right, okay, good. What we wanted to do. Conditions are currently surface wind 040, 10 knots. So we're going to be taking off runway 20. Oh yeah, there aren't any seats, so... Yeah. And then our arrival is going to be... arrival... coming in on east... So that would be runway 9. And the Pigo... I'm going to have to look this up. Let's have a look. And let's give you that screen as well. I will come. There we are. So, approaches for 119. Oh, we're going to be vectoring. misses the Piggo. Piggo what? It's a very simple time. From Daventry, the Piggo One Hotel. Lovely. And then runway. So the Piggo One Hotel is number 2. And our approach will be the ILS via Piggo. It's all in. Bloody heck, it worked. It worked. So we want fuel. So we've got 45 passengers, which is a number, and I'm just going to assume that it's right. Cargo is 3343 kilograms. Our zero fuel weight is 26684. Oh yeah, Richard deleted all of that. And then fuel on board is going to be 1642. Gross weight 2683. It's close. So, vertical 2, top of climb is going to be a 4 cal loop. You just say 5. And then here we want to be. Where do I put my cruise altitude? Oh, I can't remember how to fly this flipping plane. Pretty sure it's not that. Oh, is it performing? Really not. That's strange, but it's not allowed. Nav menu? Nope. Flight plan menu? Oh, we've just looked at that. Okay. And then, right, okay, so we arrive, all we want to do at Piggo. Oh, it's already done it, because, yeah, we had a star, didn't we? Okay, right, that's fine then. I'm slightly concerned that I can't key in. Well, at least I can't remember how to key in. Our cruise altitude.
Ladies and gentlemen, may we have your attention to the international safety regulations. This aircraft has 6 emergency exits. Two exits are located in front, 2 at the wing.
I don't know why I find that funny.
They are marked.
Right, okay. Enough farting about. Let's start pressing some buttons, eh?
Lead to these exits.
So, Apu, we want you on.
Equipped with the safety belts. To fasten the seatbelt, fit the two ends together. Tighten it by pulling the loose end. To unfasten the seatbelt, lift the upper part of the buckle. Your life vest is located under your seat and is sealed in a plastic bag. When instructed to do so, take a hold of the bag and take the life vest out. Pull the life vest over your head. Pull the struts until the life vest is properly adjusted. On leaving the aircraft, pull the threads tight and the life vest will
deflate.
Red tubes are located on both sides for blowing the additional air into the life vest. For more detailed information, please refer to the safety instruction card in a seat pocket
speeds.
In front of you. Thank you for your attention.
You need a speeds card, and I can't be bothered loading it up, so we'll wing it. I can see nothing going wrong with this whatsoever. Oh my days. Let's just set that to roughly runway heading. I think that one we're actually on the runway. And is Apu on? Apu is on! Yay! Oh, hear all the air. Fantastic. That can come on. That can come on. That's actually. They can come on. Boot air's actually fine. Air conditioning bleeds are currently off. That's fine. That's what we want. Arm the doors. Beacon light going on. Ignitions can go to norm. Oop, didn't want to press that. Never mind. Be fine. Anything up here that I care about? External power can come off. Because now we've got poo. And we can do services. Oh, it's already killed the killed that. Right, now then. Props can go to start. This one needs to be a little bit on the ball because the pushback in this thing is hilarious. And if you've not seen it, you'll see it now. Right, pushback left.
Ground, we are ready for pushback.
We are ready now, please release point break.
Parking brakes released.
Okay. Set trim, that's something
I'm going to forget. Pushing back now, clear to start the engine number 2.
There we go. Let's start number 2! Press the buttons. Oh shit, we're going the wrong way. The speed he pushes us back up. Steaming up already.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of our airline, we would like to welcome you on board of our Dash 8 Q400. The flight time today will be approximately 2 hours.
Still push back before he sends us backwards.
If you want to use
your airline,
we kindly ask you to contact us first. For takeoff and landing, these devices must be
parking brake set,
and the
cellular get clearance
phones
number
may not
one.
Be used during the entire flight. We wish you a pleasant stay.
Great pushback there, well done. Anti-skip, that's an easy one to forget. I love that noise. Oh, so good. 5 takeoff. Number one, number one, number one, that's fine.
When instructed to do so, take a hold of the bag and take the life vest out.
No, just the PTU.
Pull the life vest over your head. Fasten the life vest by connecting the hose to the ring. Pull the struts until the life vest is properly adjusted.
PTU's off.
On the neck of the aircraft, pull the threads tight and the life vest will inflate. Red tubes are located on both sides for blowing the additional air into the life vest. For more detailed information, please refer to the safety instruction card in a seat pocket in front of you. Thank you for your attention.
Steaming up, man. I'm steaming up. I can't get to that one. Taxi, usual standards. Okay, number one coming up. Lights on. Wow, we're really steaming up. Why are we steaming up?
Cabin crew, cease from departure.
I just turned this off.
Done.
Please. Oh, that one. Flicking engine up. Yes, it is. Bring it up to flight mode. What on earth is that? Bring out some proper equipment. It's more than RPMs. So your damper can come on. Probably going to need it. Everything else is fine. Don't need to press any other buttons. Maximum safety power might not be a bad show. Both engines up and running, ready to rock and roll. The windows will clear once we leave it on properly. The boot doesn't need to be on, why are you still on? That's because I'm going to turn it off. Lovely. Taxi going on. It's probably rock backtracking. guard can go away. Flaps are set, everything's good. He says, with zero confidence whatsoever, no lights. Just a quick check. Bleeds are set to min. That's what we want. Power! She's a brute. What are you doing? Where are you going, man? Full speed would be nice. We're running out of runway. Yes, I forgot. We are very heavy. We're up. We're up. Just. Okay. Oh, have we cleared the trees? Yeah, we have, just about. Alright, get that gear away. Well, not quite sure what happened there. That was weird.
Don't sink.
I'm trying not to, mate. I really am. Hold, thank you. Push that down a bit. That'll do this for speed. There we go. Happy days. Right, we're winning, we're winning. The computer's flying. we've got a chance, we've got a chance. Right, head in. Bring around, boys, bring around. Flaps away. Oh well. Drops the rate of power. There we go again. Eek a smidge more out of that. So, after takeoff checklist, taxi lights off, logo line off. Position light can stay on. Leads to normal. That'll be foggers. Keep bringing this heading back. Yeah, I can't count what the large is. Bouncing around in the wind here like an absolute trooper. And actually, we can go into Melmoth. There we go. Bit of a disgusting takeoff, but we got that. There's 220 knots, so we'll go into IAS hold. It's an airspeed hold. 220 knots, that'll be a climb speed. And we can bring the props back to 900. And that's already put us in climbing power as well. So that's IAS hold now. That'll take us up and away. So remember to press Alt Cell, so actually hold for climbable 1.70. And we're going directly about this. Weather radar should have been on ages ago. Idiot. Oh, and we just punched out the flags as well. Is it like in Worcestershire? Right, that's where it's coming, but it's dry at least. So we can turn those annoying things off. Oh, you are joking. Oh no, it's not. That's hilarious. If you stop them there, they actually stop, so you have to press a whole bar. Oh, that is quite funny. So, quick check, gear is up, flaps are up, Q&H can go over to standard. No, standard. Points can stay up for a minute. Then trim. Right. So one thing we have to do in the Dash 8. See how we're almost straight level bubble kicked off to the side? That's because the rocks both spin the same way, so we put in a bit of rudder. Rudder trim, obviously, because we're going to be holding that. And so we line up. So the rudder's just been kicked over to the right a little bit. And that means we're now straight and level. We're not constantly grabbing because of the torque of the engines. And you might just be able to see that the rudder is ever so slightly kicked. Stop it! Just say it's kicked over to the right and smidgen. Weather is disgusting down this side of the country, but it's fine, we're going to go straight over the top of it. And coming up to 10,000 feet, that's close enough for me. Lights off. That's all fine. And we can start accelerating a bit now, actually. So we just nudge up the speed a little bit. Remember, no auto throttle or anything on the Dash 8. So, auto throttle. So you can set the props to the rating power. And then you do basically IAS hold. So if you're accelerating and you're on IAS hold, it'll pitch up so you climb a bit faster. If you're decelerating, it'll go for next time. So we just keep nudging this up. If you nudge it up too fast, it'll do a nose dive to try and speed up. Because obviously, the higher up we go, the faster we will need to be. In theory, we could go into V-mode now, actually. I don't think I've set it up properly. required to hear anything that you're saying. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, from the flight deck, I am 1.5 currents of cider down. The wind is a-blowing. But at least makes it look so long. So probably going to get you get down on the ground safely. But then again, this is a dash out, so... you're carrying your chickens the moment you step on the aircraft, to be honest. So I've got no sympathy whatsoever. It's not called the crash aid for nothing. Don't land it, you fly it into the floor. You're actually on the ground, or hitting the ground is the scary bit. It hits the deck rather hard. But the thing stops like it's just hit a brick wall and it really goes. It knows that they've sped up, the rivers are slowing off, so we'll just give it one push to the left. It just stops us crabbing. Okay. A little bit more efficient to fly like that and balanced as well. There's no little bubble. You constantly feel like you're leaning to one side, it would feel really odd. And you'd spray the jets on it, of course. The water would be level, the glass would be right at the top. Which would be really, really weird. So, yeah, so mostly trimmed. Speed, we could do, we're going a bit quicker if I'm honest. Because we're struggling at this speed, so actually maintain the rate of climb. So now I moved that up too quick, so now it's doing a bit of a dive to try and increase the speed. And you want to stop it doing that. Yes, you could go into vertical speed mode, but if you lose the speed too quickly, you'll never get it back. It's a bit of a... it's a funny one in a turbo prop, because you need the speed to climb. But if you don't have the speed, you can't get it back without not even descending, depending on where it is. It's really, really odd. So what you would normally do is you want to speed up first and then climb. What we did, what they do, which is climb, speed up, take pitch hold whilst you're accelerating up to 220 knots. And then go into speed hold pretty much until your vertical speed just starts dropping away from you and getting too low, and then you start speeding up again. And just gradually increase your speed whilst trying to maintain at least a little bit of clock in terms of vertical speed. It's a bit, it's something I'm not particularly good at, not particularly familiar with the actual procedure, but I roughly what they do. They are quite heavy as well, and we'd probably stay on max RPM until you actually increase and then back it off. But again, I'm speculating. So you know, we've just sped up by 10 knots, and suddenly we've gone from vertical speed of like 10 feet per minute to about 600 feet per minute. So those extra few knots make a huge difference. Just keep nudging this up towards the barber pole. It's the red bit on the end. Two, six, five, that sounds good. And then actually when we increase, when we level off in our climb, we'll be accelerating so much, we'll actually have to back off the throttle a little bit, otherwise we'll overspeed. Devonshire is only here, so we're not actually that far away from starting on the second anyway. So there's 2 sevens here. We'll back the pumps off and go to cruise power. Oh, it's already selected cruise power. Just nudges the power back slightly. Probably see when we hit 170, if we even get to it, we'll shit on that one. The Van Davis thing for a minute. Just deleted a couple of waypoints I shouldn't have done, but it's not going to be the end of the world. We can go into ENAV and drop our prompts back, and altitude can come back there as well. So what I'm going to do is put vertical speed hold on, and we're going to drop the nose, which means we're going to accelerate like an absolute beast. So I'll bring the power back much more. Because gradually I went just absolutely ranting backwards. Now you've got a giveaway. You might just be able to see this if I can see it. Just below your throttle speed, there's an arrow. So if I do that, to slow it down, whereas if I give it the beams, now it's going to pinch the point. So basically, you don't want to see an arrow if you're trying to maintain the speed. 250 knots, I'm trying to maintain that, so I just keep an eye on it. And it gives you effectively a derivative, so it tells you when you're accelerating or slowing down, which you can see before it actually happens, of course. Don't trust that we're going to get down to 8,000 feet in that stint there. We're only going down at 600 feet a minute. Of course, we're not going particularly fast either. Is it brain speed? Oh, brain speed is 320. We just have a reasonable tailwind. Yeah, 8 knots. There's the waypoint gone. Why is it just deleted pick error? There's the VNAV coming in, so I can put it into VNAV mode now. There we go, VNAV path. So that means we're actually following the VNAV now, that's good. It can't be a million miles away, in fact is this last step? This might be last step. A roverhead pigger, okay. So I'm going to move the just to get it. That's what it's saying, isn't it? Yeah, see, we're actually plummeting towards the floor now. Because it's realised that no way it was going to make that. See how good it is, because the throttle has changed now. The torque ball has changed massively. Spoilers either, I don't think it's going to happen. Doesn't happen!
Well, not strictly true. It has spoilers, but they're automatic. Just maintain descent at a lower rate. Bring the speed back. Once the speed's good, then we can worry about our altitude. Got to get that speed back. Would be normally in the vents as we're doing the procedural approach. We wouldn't normally fly right on the departure path. To local Q&H, 1020. VNAV's coming back. So we can pick up the VNAV again for Trista. Pre-select VNAV. Speed's nice. Speed's very good actually. Coming in that way, so we can take a 515 on it. Leads to me. Hope we don't fog up too much. Rudder trim's good. Approach, right? As you can see, we'll come in, we'll break off, and then we'll do a U-ing. So make sure that speed isn't starting to increase. Very easy for speed to run away from your reserve. London, but coming to the way. In fact, please don't need to be on. I'm just worried about it. I can see. see it's folded up a little bit already. It is probably going to be so. And there's Altstar. Now then, as it put in the less frequency, 109.35.
15. All it needs. I should have let that roll, but I just wanted to show you how quickly this thing slows down when it wants to. Please come back to me. Thanks. Weather radar can come off. Let's stand by. Keep dabs of the brakes. Come off and whisk it. Ah.
taxi with the Aloids on Q4. We could go to red. Normal procedure, single engine taxi on the flagship. And it's the left engine to stop because the doors are on the left side of the aircraft. And it takes a little bit while to spool down, so if the left one's already spooled down. See how close I can get the nose wheel to the actual button. We're going for 11, not 11 left. Nose wheel is bang under my arms. Right, I'm going to guess it there. Parking brake on. Props to Feather. Request the GPU. Don't need to bother with the APU when you're parking up. There's no point. You don't need the air for anything. So that's GPU connected. It's a props away. And because we killed engine number one, we can open the door straight away. Oh! Oh! That! Oh, I'll take that! I'm even on centreline. Almost. Oh, so close. One bit of the wheel is on the tee. Wait a minute.
That's the view we want. Oh! Not quite on the tee, is it? Oh, I thought the tee was on this line. That's why I suggested it. How close can I get? Because I thought I'd noticed that was on the line and it would have been easy. And it was right under our arse. Right where the pilot is. Bang on, that is. My camera is pretty much in the headrest, actually, not where his eyes are. But the nose wheel is actually... It's further forward than I thought. I thought the nose wheel was directly under our arse. So I thought I was on this line. That's what I was aiming for. So I got what I was aiming for, but what I was aiming for wasn't what it should have been, because it was about, 6 foot, 5 foot further forward, something like that. There we go. There is a bit of a classic these days now. Unfortunately, no more flyby, but that is the Crash 8. Although we gave it a good go trying to crash it on takeoff, that was a hairy takeoff, in fairness. We gave it a bit of a go on initial descent, over speeding, and the landing, I tell you what, that is, and I'm not trying to wind you up here, that was the best landing I've ever done in this aircraft, by a margin, by a huge, huge margin. That was really good fun. I quite enjoyed that. I'd like to do the return flight. If you're interested, down in the doobly-doo. If you want more educational type videos on this channel, then let me know. If you prefer the sort of fun flying about, having a bit of a giggle type videos as well, let me know your preference there. Or, excuse me, or whether you like the mixture. Because at the moment I'm sort of shooting in the dark. I'm doing the educational videos primarily for the air cadets, but I'm happy to do that to general public. They are publicly available, of course. But if you prefer the sort of giggly videos like this, then let me know. There's some good ones, sort of older ones on the channel, particularly flying the 707, where it's the usual Friday night bottle of wine type job. But the 7.0 is particularly interesting, so it's got loads of little aerodynamic features. I can't remember the flight we did. It might have been Moscow or something to London. But yeah, I'm rambling on about all the aerodynamics and stuff like that, which I know a lot more about than the flying side of things. I know much more about the engineering that goes on behind these aircraft than I do the pilot skills and whatever. But I'll take the lights off just to finish up the parking. These can come off, that can come off, these can come off. And for some reason, disconnecting the battery doesn't actually turn everything off. That's why not? Oh, it's powered by the air conditioner. Interesting. But there we are! Down on the ground, safe and sound, a couple of miles away from where I'm currently sat. Hope you enjoyed. See you on the next one.